Hi, everyone. Welcome to the Colcord School's 2020 Virtual Athletic Banquet. Our format is a little bit different, but the end result is the same. We want to take the opportunity to honor our athletes who have put in so much hard work and dedication in the seasons they got to finish. Very proud of how our teams competed in both boys and girls across all sports. We're very thankful for our athletes, and we're thankful for our parents who allow us to have all the time with them. Athletes, we are going to have real plaques for you. We will set up a time for you to come get those, but today we want to recognize everyone who has earned an honor this year. So without further ado, let's get started with our 2020 athletic banquet.
Hello everyone, it's Coach Ortiz. I just want to welcome you all to the 2020 sports banquet. Hope everybody's staying safe out there. I'm going to do softball first. Softball, we finished 15-8, made it to the regional playoffs. I just want to say I'm extremely proud of our girls, the way they competed. They did a really good job, worked hard throughout the course of the year, and we just got way better. Played in a pretty tough district, had to travel quite a bit, but we showed up and we played pretty well. Beat some good teams. And we finished strong in the regional, so I was super proud of our season. I really want to say thank you to the seniors. You guys helped out a lot, so thank you for your effort and sticking it out. But our first award today is going to be the Most Improved Player Award. This girl, she didn't even want to play softball at the beginning. I kind of talked her into it, or kind of made her, but I was super glad she played. She got better at hitting. She had 8 strikeouts, and those were at the beginning of the year. After that, she put the ball in play most of the time. Fielding, she was great. She never hardly made an error, always know what to do with the ball. She just did a great job. But our most improved player goes to Jody Warren. Good job, Jody. I'm proud of you. The next award goes to, is the Best Pitcher Award. This girl had 50 strikeouts. She started 11 games. She didn't just pitch well, she played her position well, got outs for us when we needed it, pitched in some big games, won some big games, but she just did a great job. If she grows a little bit more, throws a little bit harder, she's going to be a lot better, but I was just super proud of her effort. She never gave up, pitched through some tough outs, and she just did a great job. But our Best Pitcher Award goes to Madison Hampton. Good job, Madison. Proud of you. Our Offensive Player of the Year goes to Peyton Crittenden. She had a 604 batting average. She switch hit. She just did a great job. She put the ball in play all the time. Just did a lot of great things. Once she got on base, she'd still just put pressure on the defense. She just did a great job. She had 29 steals. And again, a 604 batting average. That's pretty good, so especially for a freshman. I'm super proud of you, Peyton. Good job. Our Defensive Player of the Year award goes to Brittany Clapp. She has one of the best arms, best gloves I've seen in a girl, especially at her age. She just plays extremely hard. She only had 2 errors the whole season, and I'm pretty sure she can remember one like I can, but she's a sure out if it's hit to her 90%, 96% of the time she's getting out. So I'm just super proud of you, Brittany. Keep working, keep getting better. Keep improving. Good job, Brittany. The next award is our last award. It is our Most Valuable Player Award. This girl did not only played on the field well, but she did anything I asked. She is my aide. She would come and help me work on the field. She just did a lot of great things. A leader. I mean, played wherever I put her, whether it was first base, outfield, catcher. It didn't matter. She just wanted to help the team the best she could. She finished with 25 RBIs, a .455 batting average, and her fielding percentage was like 96%. So she truly deserves this award. I'm really going to miss her. But our Most Valuable Player Award goes to Michaela Fawn. Super proud of you, Michaela. Keep working. Going to miss you. I just want to say thank you to all the parents for y'all's support. Thank you to my administration and athletic director for always having my back. I just hope that we can build off this year and have a lot more success next year. But again, thank you guys.
Hey guys, this is Coach Martin. Hey, we're doing things a little bit different this year on the banquet with everything going on, but I'm going to talk about football. But first off, I just want to talk about the seniors in all sports, both boys and girls. I just want to tell you guys and girls, I'm very sorry, because I know, you know, with powerlifting and track and softball and baseball, it was all cut short, and you know, I couldn't imagine. So I'm very sorry for you guys. They got to miss out. I hope everybody and their families are safe. And I hope everything's going well. We're going to talk about some football awards. Before I do that, I just want to brag on my seniors this year in football. Blake Gonzalez, Jaden Chandler, Tyler Duncan, and Cody Weeks. I just want to tell you guys, I appreciate you guys so much. I'm going to miss you guys. All us coaches and players will. And you guys are always welcome. You know, call me up, come to the field house, hang out at the games, continue our relationship. And you guys have done so much for me. I truly do appreciate you guys. Thank you so much. Okay, we're going to talk about the awards. Our district gets together and votes on, basically we try to put together a team out of our whole district. Our district, we're Class A, we're District 6, in 2019 and 18 we were, and we get together 8 head coaches, and we pretty much, we meet up, and we vote, and the best of the best are on the list. So I'm going to tell you guys who won these awards, and talk about some stats maybe here and there. And anyway, the first one, this young man had 1,000 yards, I know, last year rushing, and he led the team last year in receiving. And then this year, he was another 1,000-yard rusher this year. And he even between punt returns or kick returns, and passing yards combined also with the rushing yards, he was probably somewhere around 1,700 or 1,800 yards total yards. That's amazing. And it's no doubt that this kid deserves the Offensive Player of the Year in our district. Blake Gonzalez, congratulations, buddy. Blake also was a Class A All-Star by class. And what that means is they pretty much, in each classification, they take the top 26 in each classification. We're Class A. I send info, and coaches from other towns, and they look at their stats, they look at their profile, they look at their film, and they basically sit there, and the best of the best are on this list. And Blake Gonzalez was Class A, All-Star by class. That's top 26 in the state for Class A. Congratulations, buddy. Well-deserved. Also getting that reward while we're talking about that is Jaden Chandler. Jaden Chandler, so, you know, he made it as a linebacker. Blake, he made it as a running back. So that's basically saying, you know, Blake Gonzalez and Jaden Chandler, they're top 26. So what an award to win. Very proud of both of you guys. Jaden was also voted on District A6 Outside Linebacker of the Year. And like I said, we're trying to build a team. They voted him as an outside linebacker, the best in our district. So congratulations, Jaden. Thank you for all that you've done for us and being such a great leader. Next one is on the linemen is we vote. We basically fill 5 linemen. We get our best 5 linemen and out of the whole district. And this young man, when he was put up for a vote, he got on there, and I was so thankful. And I'm also thankful that we have one more year with this young man, Mr. AJ Nichols. Is Offensive Lineman of the Year in our district. And I'm so excited for his senior year coming up next year. He's been working super hard. So thank you so much, AJ. Congratulations. Okay, next up is Cody Weeks. Cody Weeks, like I said, moved in. It took us a practice or two, and we knew right offhand he could tackle. He was physical. He had a nose for the ball. That's what you want on defense. And he led the team in tackles, and he also won inside linebacker of the year in our district. Cody, congratulations. Well deserved. We're going to miss you as well. Thank you, buddy. Okay, this young man, he started for me on defense. He plays both ways, plays special teams. He does it all, but he was a leader for us, even as a freshman on defense. He is a coach on the field, a quarterback on the field, whatever you want to say. He got us lined up. He got us in the right coverage. He got people bumped over, moved back, whatever he needed to do. He did it. When I couldn't relay what I needed to, he already had it done anyways. So this is a well-deserved award, and got two more years of this young man, Stormy Odell. He won the Safety of the Year in our district. Congratulations, Stormy. Thank you for being such a good leader and student of the game. Okay, also, we're going to talk about our All-District. So All-District, those were special awards, and this was these aren't the individual awards necessarily, like Offensive Player of the Year or Outside Linebacker. It's just more clear and cut. It's just the All-District. These young men received All-District honors as well. Tyler Duncan, like I said, he's a senior, played tight end. We moved him to the O-line, and we talked to him about it, and he said, "Coach, whatever will help the team, I'm there." And so proud of him. I'm going to miss him. And thank you so much, Tyler. Next up's Dylan Davis. Dylan, he can play, you know, he's got great hands. He's very smart on defense, offense. You can put him at multiple spots on both sides. And having those guys is so critical for us. And we appreciate you so much, Dylan, for being such a good young man and all you do for the program. And next up's Trenton Lynch. Trenton Lynch, tough as nails, and he'll do anything a coach asks. He is physical. Like I said, he's tough. And, you know, I always think he weighs about 240 pounds, and he probably only weighs about 160. So he plays bigger than he really is, and he's full speed. It doesn't matter if it's a practice, a game, a walkthrough. He's full speed, and he's going to do things right. And that's so important. Every coach wants a Trenton Lynch, I promise you. So thank you so much for what you do, Trent. Okay, next up, Hayden Duncan. Hayden Duncan is also an inside linebacker. Him and Cody were inside linebackers. We didn't have to worry too much about the inside linebackers. They're physical, they're tough, always at practice, practiced hard, played harder. And to play inside linebacker, you got to be tough. And these young men, Hayden was, you know, I talked about Stormy being the leader on the defensive backs. I know for sure, like on defense. Well, Hayden was a leader for us on our front seven guys, getting us lined up. Between him and Jaden, they got us lined up, they got the calls in, and we were always sound. So thank you so much, Hayden, for all you've done. George Phillips, you know, you talk about tough. There's probably a common denominator on a lot of these fellas on you know, this team of Hornets is they're tough. And may not win them all, and sometimes we may be outmatched, but these young men give it all they got. And George is one of those young men. He's tough, and he plays hurt. I know the last two or three games, two or three different body parts were hurt. If it was an elbow or shoulder or knee or ankle or whatever. And he just, "Coach, I'm letting you know, my elbow's hurt, I'm playing. I'm just letting you know. If you see me not practicing very good, what's going on? George is a very tough young man, so fun to watch on Fridays. He's a gamer, and you know, the great thing about these last four men, like Dylan and Trent and Hayden and George, I talked about AJ earlier, all those guys are juniors, going to be senior, they're seniors now. So all those guys are seniors. I talked about Stormy, he's going to be a junior on the next season. So the future is so bright for these guys. And that's probably the next thing I want to talk about is, first off, thank you all seniors this year, seniors last year, for, you know, basically clearing a path for, you know, the future Hornets. And I think the future is so bright. We got a lot of talent, a lot of tough kids coming up, and I'm so excited to be a part of it. It's going to be fun. We got to work out, and that's one thing, you know, that I would want to kind of sneak in this video is let's not take anything for granted. Let's get after it and hook up when it's time to go again. Let's get after it double time. And I'm so excited for the, you know, next season to be here. And I'm so proud of everyone on our team. I'm so proud of you guys. The time it takes, you know, it takes away from family and everything else. I know, but I'm very proud of everything you guys do. And I had so much fun the last 2 years. And it's good to be a Hornet. And thank you. You know, just thank you for working hard. And we're going to have some fun next year. Thank you so much.
Hey guys, this is Miss Chamberlain. I hope you are all doing well. I first just want to thank Mr. Denny for putting this together so that we can recognize our kids for what they have accomplished this year. This is my second year of being the Colcord High School cheer coach, and it has been nothing short of amazing. I had a great group of girls this year that I could not be more proud of. They worked so well together, and I know the underclassmen truly looked up to the seniors. When I think of Colcord cheer, I think of the words, one heart, one team, one goal, one dream. The bonds that these girls form is truly amazing to watch. I want to thank the seniors for their leadership on this squad. You are leaving big shoes to fill, but your attitudes, leadership, and responsibility to the squad have made it easier for the younger girls to follow in your footsteps. These girls are my family that I love to pieces. We often spend more time with each other than we do our own families. With that, I would like to thank you, parents, grandparents, and families of these 11 amazing young ladies for trusting and allowing me to be a part of their lives. I will cherish the memories that I have made with these girls for as long as I can remember them. I will be giving out 4 awards today, with the first one being the Outstanding Freshman Award. First, I would like to take a minute to talk about my amazing freshmen. These girls came into cheer tryouts with little to no confidence at all. No amount of pep talks could put their minds at ease. From the time these 5 ladies made the squad, they have come so far. They have accomplished so much in just 1 year. I'm excited to see what they can do in the next 3. From their jumps to their stunts, they have worked so hard, and it really shows. Many times they would ask me what they could do to be better, and I love that about them. They are always striving to be better. I am so proud of you girls. The young lady that is receiving this award is a cheerleader that brings so much good to the squad. From her attitude to her skill on the sidelines, she really has it all. Seeing her become more confident in herself has been so fun to watch. This girl stepped away out of her comfort zone and would call cheers on the sidelines, which can be very intimidating as a freshman in front of a crowd of many. Her motions are phenomenal, and she has great jumps. This girl has taken a hard fall from the very top of an extended stunt. However, she didn't let it stop her from continuing to be a fearless flyer. She does things that I ask of her in stunts that she may not have confidence in, but she does it anyways. And I'm so, so proud of everything that she has accomplished this year. She's a light on the cheer squad and has a big future ahead of her. The Outstanding Freshman Award is going to go to Miss Kalisha Lewis. Congratulations, Kalisha. I'm so proud of you. The next award is the Outstanding Sophomore Award. My 2 sophomore girls have hearts of gold. They inspire everyone they are around to be better. And I always say that I need a mom purse, and it's because of these two girls. Whether it is medication or a snack to help blood sugar, they always need something, and I usually don't have it. So girls, maybe next year my mom purse is going to be better. They have had a tough year due to some health issues, but they never let it stop them from making the most of their year. These girls will be great leaders next year as they have really stepped up and were awesome examples and represented our squad and school in the best way. I am so, so proud of you girls. The young lady that is receiving this award is a girl who brings so much positivity to the squad on and off the sidelines. I've heard countless remarks from the crowd about her smile. She's always smiling while she cheers, and I absolutely love that about her. She's so much fun to watch. She is a great cheerleader, not only with skill, but spirit as well. She has a heart for helping others, and it shows on the squad. There are a couple of games where she was the upperclassman as a sophomore and led the squad without hesitation. I know the underclassmen really look up to her, and I'm so excited to watch her cheer over the next couple of years. I know that she's going to accomplish great things. The Outstanding Sophomore Award is going to go to Miss Megan Chandler. Congratulations, Megan. I'm so proud of you. The next group of girls I would like to brag on are my seniors. Wow, what a great group of girls. I know these girls will do great things. The creativity they bring to the squad is amazing. Their leadership is impeccable. I have watched the underclassmen come to tears when talking about next year with these girls, without these girls in the squad. That is a great testament to what these four girls mean to each and every one on the squad. They are the whole package and every cheer coach's dream. They have brought many laughs to the squad as their humor is like none other. Each of my senior cheerleaders were selected by the entire student body to walk in homecoming. That says so much about their personality and their hearts. The young lady who will be receiving the Outstanding Senior Award is a cheerleader who has it all from her contagious smile, her motions, her jumps, her stunts, her attitude, and her spirit. She is the best all around. She is dynamite in a little package. Her confidence is admirable. The squad trusts her and looks to her for guidance and advice, and I love how she took on the freshmen with open arms and was a great mentor to them on the squad. I'm going to miss her so much, but I am so excited to see what she accomplishes in the future. I know that she will become an amazing teacher and an awesome cheer coach. The Outstanding Senior Award is going to go to Miss Laramie Shelley. Congratulations, Laramie. I am so, so proud of you, and I'm going to miss seeing you on the sidelines next year. My final award I will be giving is the Hornet Character Award. This award means so much to me as it represents what I want for the Colcord Cheer Squad. My girls have heard me say over and over that I want them to represent Colcord schools in the best way. In and out of uniform, my girls are the spirit of the school, and I want them to have pride in that. From academics to character to sidelines, the young lady receiving this award represents Colcord High School and cheer so well. She has left an everlasting impact on Colcord schools, and I hope that she takes pride in everything that she has accomplished. She has been a great role model to the other cheerleaders on the squad, and I could not be more proud of her. She has a bright future ahead of her, and I know that she will accomplish many great things. The Hornet Cheer Character Award goes to Miss Julia Haggard. Congratulations, Julia. I am so proud of you, and I'm going to miss you being a part of the Colcord Cheer Squad. To my girls, I am so incredibly proud of you and what you have accomplished this year. I love and miss you so much. And to my seniors, you will forever have a place in my heart. You have represented Colcord well, and I am so very proud of you. Always remember Philippians 4:13, and you will do great things. I love you all, and I miss you. God bless.
Hello, everyone. It's Coach Ortiz again. Now we're going to do basketball awards. Our basketball season, we finished 9-13. We had some pretty good games, beat some pretty good teams. We just struggled at times just because we were so young and inexperienced. But overall, our effort was always there, usually. We played hard. I was just super proud of our girls. They just played with a lot of effort. And for not being used to being pushed and stuff, they responded pretty well. I'm just extremely proud of how we the season turned out. Wish we could have made it a little bit further in playoffs, but it happened to be that the sickness got us at the end, and I just hated it for our girls because I thought we was good enough to win some playoffs games. But just, like, again, just extremely proud of how we played this year considering our inexperience and youth. But, man, we grew up, and it was a great season. I had a lot of fun. But our first award that I'm going to give out is our most improved player. This girl, she started out, she didn't even, wasn't sure if she wanted to play or not, but she came in there and she worked her butt off. Her efforts nonstop, defensively, offensively, she just gives it everything she has. And as a coach, that's somebody that you want on your team, and she improved drastically from the beginning to the end. I was just super proud, and she loves to work, so I expect many more good things from her. Our most improved player goes to Madison Hamilton. Good job, Maddie. Keep working. Proud of you. Our next award goes is the best shooter award. This girl spent a lot of time just working on her shot, feet, working on follow through. I mean, she just did a great job. She hit some big shots for us during the course of the year. Had some big games, and she just continually works on her shot. She's always asking me questions or doing stuff to help her improve. But the best shooter award goes to Shani Barbie. Good job, Shani. Proud of you. The next award is our offensive player of the year. This young lady just works constantly. Works on shooting, passing. Our point guard got in trouble. She'd step in there and help bring the ball down. Yeah, she was nervous a bit. I had to get on her and give her some confidence to make sure she could do it. And she realized she could. She's just a great offensive player. Her career high was 25, and that was the first game of the year. She lit it up. She had a few more games during the course of the year like that. But she's just a great all-around player. Offensive rebounds, assists, shots. She can do it all. Our offensive player of the year goes to Jody Warren. Good job, Jody. Proud of you. Our defensive player of the year, this girl would get after you. I'm telling you, if her energy would stay consistent the whole time, I don't think anybody would ever score on her. She loves to play defense because she says she's not very good at offense, but I disagree. She's pretty good at both. But defensively, nobody wanted her to guard them. I mean, she'd frustrate you, be people pushing her hands off. I mean, she'd just be on you in practice. Nobody wanted her to guard them because she would get after them. She's just a great defensive player. I know her offense is going to catch up with that defensive effort, but just super proud of her. I mean, she's just a lockdown defender. I'm glad that she continues to work hard. She's going to be really good. But our defensive player of the year goes to Paris Kirby. Good job, Paris. Proud of you. And the last award is our most valuable player. This girl did it all for us. Defensively, probably averaged 5 steals. Offensively, 9-10 points, 2-3 assists. Controlled the game, controlled the ball. Just did whatever I asked of her. At times, we butted heads, but she was just a great overall player. She's young, and sky's the limit for her. She's just a really good player. She just shares the ball, not selfish at all. And sometimes I wanted her to be more selfish, and she was like, well, I just feel like I need to get my team involved. And I'd be like, well, you got to go score. We need you. And she did. She did a great job. She made all conference for a freshman. She was the only freshman in our whole entire conference to make all conference. So that was a big plus. Just looking forward to how much she progresses over the next few years. Just super proud of her. Our most valuable player goes to Peyton Crittenden. Peyton, keep working, and you're going to have a lot of success. Super proud of you. But I'd just like to thank all the parents, my athletic director, the administration parents for sticking with me and backing me up through tough times, because the season was tough at times, but I just appreciate all the support I get, and I'm really going to miss the seniors that we had. You guys continue to work hard, and Come back and support us if you can. But I'm going to miss you guys deeply. Again, everybody stay safe out there. And girls, I can't wait to see you soon. We'll see y'all.
All right, hello, guys. Hey, this is how we're doing our athletic banquet this year. So I wanted to get in touch with you and tell you that I miss you guys. I hope you all are healthy. Hope everything's going good for you and your family. I want to talk about our season. We had a great season this year. We finished 13-12, had a winning season. We're building on what we started. And you guys, this team, this year we took another step in the regional, got to the second round of regionals. You guys are just building things that it's just going to keep going up and up from here on out. I appreciate you guys. I appreciate your hard work. I appreciate your dedication. I appreciate everything you guys have given to us coaches and the school and the program and everything that you just do. I really appreciate you guys. I'm really missing you guys.
Okay,
we're going to start with our awards. We're going to start out with the first award goes to a guy that I tried to think of everything that he did for this program in the years that he's been with me for 3 years. I was his assistant when he's a sophomore, head coach's junior, head coach's senior year. The best way I can explain this award to give to him is called the Hustle Award. I never had to worry about him ever not hustling, given everything he did. He played defense hard. He rebounded hard. He was about maybe 5'9", 5'10", at the most, but was always banging, rebounding, diving on the ball, or diving on the floor for a ball, just doing everything he needed to do to get on the floor and to help the team. So the Hustle Award this year goes to Merrick Ellis. Okay, our next award is going to be a co-defensive player award, defensive player of the year award. I couldn't decide on the two that are going to get it. One will be Stormy Odell. The next one will be Dylan Davis. They're our co-defensive players of the year. Stormy, quick as a cat. You know, anybody had a good point guard, he's on him, locking him down. Dylan's the same way. Any guards that we needed guard, these two took the challenge and they guarded well all year long, played real good defense. So I couldn't decide on one, so I gave a co-defensive player of the year award, and that goes to Dylan Davis and Stormy Odell. Okay, our last award goes to our offensive player of the year. He led us in scoring, double digits. He had a double-double pretty much about every game, rebounding and scoring. He averaged double-digit scoring. He averaged double-digit rebounding. He led us offensive rebounding. So the greatest thing about it is he's just a freshman, and we get him for 3 more years. Our offensive player of the year award goes to Ian Williams. Okay, guys, like I said, I miss you guys. Can't wait to see you again. As soon as we can get in the gym, we're going to get there for you underclassmen, okay? You seniors, can't tell you how much I appreciate you and how much I love you. I love all of you and I miss you. Now, here's the deal. You underclassmen, get a ball in your hand, ball handling skills, dribble that thing, and shoot and shoot and shoot the basketball as much as you can, all right? Stay in shape, keep getting stronger, get that basketball in your hands and get to work, and then as soon as we can get in the gym, we're going to get in there and we're going to get to work. I'm going to keep on building on what we started building on right here. So you guys stay healthy and keep working hard, all right?
Hey, it's Coach Martin. Just want to talk about powerlifting. Our season was cut short. We didn't have our state weight meet, but I still want to tell you guys our state qualifiers, our 4 state qualifiers were Reese B. Champ, Trey Duncan, Kyle King, and Blake Gonzalez. They would have went to the state weight meet and participated in that, but with everything going on, it was canceled. Kyle and Blake were regional champs in their weight class, and Blake was going into he was going in the state weight meet ranked number one and was most likely going to win a third in a row state championship. He's back-to-back state champion right now, and he most likely would have won 3 in a row. He qualified for state all 4 years, and he's also a national champ. And he would have probably been a national champ again this year, but it was also canceled as well. I'm proud of Reese, Trey, Kyle, Blake. Thank you for all that you've done. And Blake, we're going to miss you in the weight room. Very proud of all that you've done and your work ethic, and thank you all.
Hello, parents, players, and I put a little short video together just to talk a little bit and We'll talk about this year. As you know, we didn't. Our spring sports didn't. We're not going to hand out any awards because of the being cut so short. But I would like to say a few things about some of my players, and I'd like to talk about getting knocked down just real quickly. The last two seasons have been cut short for you softball players. I just want you to know that players, it doesn't define you when you get knocked down. Everybody gets knocked down, and parents, maybe somebody else watching this, it's how you respond and how you get back up. And if you get back up, and I encourage you to this time getting knocked down to get back up and respond. Think back and enjoy the times that you had, but respond in a positive way. And parents, I'd like to tell you thank you so much for allowing me to coach your kids. I love them. I love them so much. And players, I want you to promise me this. If there's that opportunity that you're still in this area 10, 15 years from now, when you decide to have kids, that maybe they can come to Colcord, and I hope that they can be Hornets just like you. And we want good, strong Hornets. And so that would be your children. So if you are in this area, promise me you'll make them Hornets, okay? Would like to say a few things about the players. We played four games. I believe that we were on our way to having a successful season. I don't know how good. I believe that our team's coming up in many sports to have an opportunity to be state qualifiers, state championship contenders, to be honest. But that's being positive. I believe that's what we have in store. And I think this team could have been a very good playoff team. I think we had the capability, the tools to do that. And I want to start off by talking about our seniors. Michaela Vaughn, or Map, as you know her, she was the utility player of every coach's dream. She was your practice player of every coach's dream. And sometimes she went too hard, but over the years, the last year especially, she matured and brought it down to a coachable, really coachable level, and was a really good player for us for all those 4 years. She played, I believe she was a 4-year starter. I'm not sure she started as a freshman, but a perfect utility player. Always done what you ask, and went above that. And that's why I nominated her for the VIP Area Player of the Year. And so that's a little bit about Map. Butts, I believe Butts had potential to be whatever she wanted. Very, very athletic, I believe, kid. And always enjoyed hollering at Butts. It's one of my favorite words to say. But Butts was probably going to have a great year at the plate. I could see it coming. She put one out at Ketchum, and I know that she was going to have many more. But consistent outfielder, could put her out there, and she could make the catch. I'm just thankful for Butts. Had a knee surgery. And had a record time of turnaround to where she could play in basketball. And I knew she'd play softball, slow pitch. So there she is out there, and didn't have any trouble at all playing. Red, Delaney Davis, probably the biggest turnaround from 1 year to the next that I've seen was Delaney. You know, this year she was one of the leaders, wanting to get out and practice, and not much negativity at all. But this year, But she was a mature player who gave us a great chance to win. She was our pitcher this year. Excellent. Excellent job at pitching the four games. And I just can't say thank you enough for coming back a mature player. That's just that says a lot about you. And I hope that going forward that projects you into whatever you do, that your maturity just continues. Abby, best friend's daughter. Abby played ball a long time. I remember going to a lot of Abby's games. Hard to believe that it's over with for these careers. But Abby had knee problems. Couldn't run very good. I'll say didn't run very good, but couldn't run very good. Couldn't run very well. But I could always count on Abby. I could put her at different positions over the years when she played third, second, and first, I believe. And I just love the fact that I was able to coach Abby. And I believe that she was going to have a great year at the plate. You could see her body had matured, and you could tell that she was more comfortable at the plate and able to get that big strong frame onto the ball, and we were going to have a good year. And I hate that it's cut short, but it's the way it is. That's the way it is. And I'm thank you Abby for playing and me getting to coach you. And then we got Laramina. Laramie, try not to cry, but one of the greatest blessings of a coach is to be able to coach your own kid. And Laramie didn't play after a few years of playing kids, youth sports. She had taken time out and come back, I believe, as a freshman and played for Miss Sappington and Coach Hendren, and she ran the bases. And then I got the opportunity as when there was a sophomores, these girls were sophomores, to help. And Laramie got to play in the outfield a little bit and got to hit. And that was a blessing for me. And I can't remember what year it was. It was probably last year sometime. But Laramie said something that every coach probably wants to hear. And it's even more special when it's your child. But she said to me, "Dad, thanks for not giving up on me. And thanks for pushing me. And you coaches that are out there, maybe watching this, and players, I want you to remember that the kids don't want you to give up on them. And Laramie become a pretty consistent outfielder. Oh, there was times when you'd have to shake your head and wonder what she was thinking or doing. But consistent. Thank you, Laramie. And thank you, seniors. And if I go down the row, I could spend all day talking about each player. But I just want you to know that I had a great time in the four games that we played. I hope you did. I hope you look forward to next year, no matter who's coaching, whether it's me or someone else. And I hope that you take what I've said, take what you've learned this year, and you apply it to next year in sports or in academics. That when you get knocked down, you get back up. And remember that you need to have the attitude of, I hope nobody gives up on me. Well, you have to keep trying and you have to get up. So thank you, parents, and thank you, players. Thank you, administration, for allowing me to coach. And also want to give a shout out to Coach Chloe Price. I enjoyed you helping, and it was rewarding seeing you hit your first grounder and get better at that, hitting pop flies. I know it was a new thing for you. So I appreciate you helping me this year. Thank you. We'll see you again when we get to do this again. Come on.